So this video will be a quick practice on comments and also constants, essentially. So we'll start off with comments. So a comment is basically something that you write into the program or into the file, whatever you want to call it, that you can read, but the machine, when you run it, doesn't actually read it. This is so that you can comment on the work you've done and explain it, or write notes basically in your work to explain things in the work, maybe even out of the work if you want, whatever the context is. And there are two types of comments. There's one called a single line comment, which is like this. This is a single line comment, and you basically use two forward slashes. You use two forward slashes to make one. A single line comment. Allows you to comment on one line. So essentially, once I get to the next line, you can see here that it's white, and I can put a variable. Let's call it variable num1, because we'll use this later. It's equal to 9, and you can see that when I run this, well, I'll actually print that. See, when I run this, I get a 9, okay? But none of this is printed. It doesn't seem to do anything to the program. There's no errors. Because, as I said, these comments are essentially here just to explain things, right? Okay, so we've made our variable. We are actually going to talk about constants. So remember, I showed you that basically constants never change, but variables can change. So we'll say that num1 is now equal to 12. Right, and we'll print num1. If you go to my GitHub, you'll actually see I pretty much explain all these things and I put comments in them. I'm going to comment here, so I'm going to use a single line comment here and say this is where we assign a new value to the variable num1, right? Because we're assigning a value of 12. So there's your single line comment to explain that. And essentially what this shows is that a variable, its value can be changed. You can create it and give it an initial value, but that value will stay the same. Now let's get into a multi-line comment. So a multi-line comment is essentially exactly the same as a single line comment, except you can write stuff into multiple lines. So if I put print, well, that would be an error if it ran. Print this, and I'll put another print statement here. None of this should get printed. And I'll explain the above. Doesn't get printed because it is inside a multi-line comment. Okay, and a multi-line comment ends with this asterisk and forward slash. So it starts with a forward slash followed by an asterisk, this here, and it ends with an asterisk followed by a forward slash. And now the thing down here can be printed. So I'm going to print this will be printed. It is not commented out. Simple. There you go. Now you can see that these print statements haven't actually been executed, even though I click run, and that's because they are within the multi-line comment. Okay? And in that multi-line comment, I've explained what this is. I've explained a part of my code with a comment. Right? You see that there? If I wrote this below here, this would become an error because it's not actually anything. Right? Anyway, that's that rant over. So that's, single line comments, multi-line comments, and also showing that you can assign a new value to a variable. Okay, that's all of that done. Now let's go into constants. So in order to make a constant, you need to use the keyword let And we'll make a constant, we'll call it number 2, and we'll say it's equal to 901. And we print num2, and that should work if I can get my typing correct. So we've got 901 there, along with everything previous. Now, if we reassign a value to number 2, as we try to do with number 1, it won't work because it's a constant. And you can never change its value, right? So that hasn't worked because it's a constant. It's not a variable. It can never vary. It must always be the value it was assigned with. So it was assigned a value of 901, and it will always be 901, even if you try and change it. Okay? This, on the other hand, it's assigned the value of 9, but it's variable, so it can vary. You can put the value to 12 later on. All right? That's it. Comment that out. We'll go through one more example, and we'll say let name equals, I don't know, Sarah Hidara. Strange name, but fair enough. If that is your name, it is a strange name, but you know, good for you having a strange name. And we'll print name. Right, so this will work. I'll just run in it so I can confirm to you that'll work, and this has worked as well. And then I'm going to try and change name to, I don't know, Gupta Singh or something like that. Put a capital. We'll try and put a bit of effort into it, eh? And it won't work. Because Gupta Singh is an evil name. No. I'm just kidding. It's because it's a constant. You can't change a constant. And we know it's a constant because we've used the let keyword and not the variable keyword. Okay? So this will never change. This value here can never be changed. And if you try and change it, you get an error. So don't try and change it. I'm going to comment that out so it doesn't run. And that's it. You know, multi-line comments, use them. Start them like this and use them over multiple lines. End them like this. Let to declare a constant, and variables can change value. Thank you for watching, and hope you enjoyed.